Today, we are going to learn about tenses. Tenses can be expressed into three types, which means the past, the present, and the future. We use tenses to express different situations. We express in past, present, and future. So today, let us see the present tense. The present tense can be expressed into four forms: the present continuous tense, the present simple tense, the present future tense, and the present future continuous. But today, we are going to start with the simple present tense. This is a form of the verb which express habits. It helps to show the actions which tend to be repeated. To form the present simple tense, you have to follow the following rules. When using the third person singular, that is he, she, and it, you have to add S or ES to the verb. For example, he goes to school every day. You have used the third person singular, he, plus the verb go. You have to add ES to the verb go. So it becomes he has gone to school. He goes to school every day. She always sings well. You have used the third person singular, she, plus SE to the verb sings. It drinks milk. You have used the third person singular, it, and you add S to the verb drinks. When using the first person singular and plural, that is I and we, the first person singular is I and its plural is we. Don't add anything to the verb. As otherwise, when you use the second person singular and plural, that is you, we don't add anything to the verb. When using the third person plural, that is they, we also don't add anything to the verb. Use words like always, often, usually, daily, normally, etc., etc., to show the habitual actions. To form a question, use do or does, but don't add SE or ES to the verb when forming a question. For example, does. We say, does he play, we say, does he play football? When using does, we don't add anything to the verb, even if we have used the third person singular. So we say, does he play football? No S to the verb play. He play, the S has already been added here to the verb do and become does. So we say, does he play football? Do they help their parents? Does Mary read loudly? Do we go to school daily? To form a negative statement or form negative statements, use do not and does not, but do not add S to the verbs. For example, I do not understand this question. Here we have used do not plus the verb understand, no S. She does not go to school every day. We have used the third person singular she plus does not, but no S to the verb go. So we say she does not go to school every day. We do not read loudly. We do not read loudly. No S to the verb read. They do not help me. They do not help me. No S to the verb help. It does not drink milk. We have used the third person it, but the verb drink has no S. ES, or let's say S, has already been added here to the verb do. So we say it does not drink milk always. All those are examples about the simple present tense. The tense which tells us about habitual actions, the actions which tend to be repeated, the actions which take place always, often, usually, daily, normally, and so on. So, thank you for listening, and okay, I want to leave you with this homework to be done while you are at home. The homework of 10 questions. Change the following into a question. Number one, he looks at the blackboard. Number two, my house is on fire. Number three, we sleep at night. Number four, she buys story books. Number five, they compare their beauty. Number six, I learn to school. Number seven, Juma sends me a nice pen. Number eight, you hear them shouting. Number nine, he lives in another village. Number ten, he blows a whistle. Thank you for listening. See you next time.